Megaman X2 Part 3, and today we will be taking on Flamesag and Morph Moth. So let's get right into it. So anyways, the gimmick to this stage is the rising lava in the first part, and the lava just throughout the stage, but again, it's pretty short. This game has really short stages for some reason. But, I mean, short and sweet, nothing wrong with that. Anyways, we're going to be getting a heart tank in this area. It's not too hard to get, although you do have to be pretty quick to get it. So, as you can see, there's lava rising. We just gotta dash jump fast enough to get here, get the heart tank, and then get out of there. And luckily we did it, so that was pretty easy. Anyways, we're just gonna continue on. Nothing particularly interesting left to say about this stage. So basically we're just gonna dash jump on these things. This area can be pretty annoying because there are enemies that will fly down and basically ruin your platforming. But it's fine. Nothing too dumb. So, okay, I did get hit. You should be able to. There is a sub tank in the stage, although I can't get that without the life upgrade, which I will probably be getting next episode because it's just really easy to get, and the boss of that stage is also pretty easy. But anyways, we're at the boss of this stage, who is pathetically easy with the weakness. It's actually one of the biggest problems with the Mega Man X series bosses, is that when you use the weakness, the boss AI just resets, and then you can react to it very easily, which is why sometimes I just like fighting bosses without the weakness, because it makes it a lot more interesting. But anyways, we're just gonna do this. No reason not to. And just to be disrespectful, we are going to do this. There we go. So anyways, we're going to be doing Morph Moth stage, and we can actually get some armor there now that we have the S-Wheel from Will Gator, which is another reason to go to that stage, by the way. So anyways, let's continue. Ding, dum, bum, bum, bum. And we got the... I really don't know. Because I skipped it, but it's essentially like you shoot fire out of the arm cannon, and the charged version actually lets you get some neat stuff like heart tanks and stuff. We will be returning to Wheel Gator's stage for that. But other than that, it's not too notable for... Yeah, S-Burner. It's kind of like an air dash, basically, when it's charged. If that makes any sense. So anyways, the armor is coming up right about here. You just do this, and it will break the stage, basically. And then we can fall down here and get to the capsule. Mega Man X, enter the capsule. This enhancement will modify your body armor. With it, you can absorb damage and transfer it into explosive weapon energy. So this is pretty nice, and it will obviously demonstrate what it does. Personally, I've never used this ability, I just don't find it that useful. Plus, you have to charge it up. But, as you can see, it'll basically be a screen nuke if you ever need that. So, if you're playing along, that can come in handy if you're newer to the games. But personally, again, I don't really use it. Anyways, there's not much left to this stage. Again, very short. But it is nice to get that armor, and we do have the weakness to the boss, so might as well. So anyways, I like having the double charge shot for this because Basically, as soon as that pink thing goes inside this robot, I can basically do this. And then I can charge it again. And it's dead. And as you can see, that's very easy to do. So, by all means, if you have it, use it. It's very convenient. And here's some energy for a sub tank. Although we basically have no energy, but that's fine. We won't need any. Although if I can, I will go up here. Nope. Oh well, I won't SD over it or anything. Just make sure to like not dash jump into those, and you should be fine overall. As you can see, there's a lot of enemies here. Just run. It's not worth to fight those things unless you're trying to get energy drops. In which case, I mean, you might guess, but personally, I wouldn't suggest it. And one of those mini bosses is coming up again, so I'm going to charge up the Buster. Anyways, let's charge it up again. And we killed him before he could even go back to the ground. So, basically, the rest of the stage is just getting to the boss, which is going to be fairly easy. And there's some energy for our sub tank. Basically, we want to use the S wheel for that thing because it one shots it and you don't have to deal with it, which is really nice. So, anyways, it's boss time. Okay, so basically the first form of this boss, he'll, as you can see, spin around and throw a bunch of junk everywhere. Nothing too dangerous though. He'll also fall into the ground. Just to be annoying, but again, nothing too dangerous. He'll also spin around, as you can see, where he had to do that, basically. But we're already on his second form. I'm gonna go up to speed. Safe. Or he turned into a moth, and this is where it can be pretty tricky, because as you can see, that contact damage is insane. But overall, nothing too hard. And the boss is dead, so this will be pretty important. This ability will let you farm sub-tanks in Purple Crab stage, but anyways, if you liked the video, like, comment, and possibly subscribe, and I'll see you next time.